Good morning, Davao. Good morning, Mindanao. Good morning, North, South, East, and West. This is Gilbert Lopez Martiecaso. For the headlines, weather forecast, easterlies affecting Mindanao. Local news, environmental group urge action versus Sitio Kalatong encroachers. Australian firm eyes Davao WTE project. Councilor proposes blogger body for responsible tourism promotion. CAAP Davao monitors ACQ's helicopter flights since May 1. National news. Filipino activists and fishermen sail in 100 boat flotilla at dispute Shual guarded by China. Guagua mayor suspends class work on May 17. International news. Ukraine troops pull back in Kharkiv after Russia offensive. Defense for Bob Menendez cast blame on senator's wife. Entertainment news. Luke Newton and Nicola Colant get a glow up in season 3. Katrina Gray looking forward to becoming Mrs. Melby this year. For the sports news, season 86 title shows NU Ladies Bulldogs more than Alisa Velia tandem, says Captain Aaron Pangilinan. Rutgers never had any doubt about Celtic title challenge. Featured stories, a Korean feast that honors Buddha birth. Lumpia Queen Abby Marquez wins a 2024 Webby Awards in NYC. For the side stories, for the trivia, do you know that the iconic Philippine flagpole, one of the tallest in the country, is located in Davao City? Weather forecast. Mindanao will be partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers and thunderstorms due to easterlies. Light to moderate winds from east to northeast with slight to moderate seas. Local news. An advocate from Davao City-based environmental group emphasized that the city government should confidently enforce its rules against encroachers in Sitio Kalatong, Barangay Tawantawan, Baguio District. Nganong hadlok man ang LGU nga implement or execute ang policy niya nga dapat ang mahadlok kay ang mga nag-violate. So, dapat sila ang careful nga nangisilip na sa LGU. Why is that LGU hesitant to implement its policies when it's the violators who should be concerned and careful, knowing that the LGU is already watching them? Questioned Attorney Mark Pinalver, Executive Director of Interfacing Development Interventions for Sustainability IDIS, or IDIS, in a media interview on April 15 at the Davao City Investment and Promotion Center, DCIPC. He emphasized that the urgency of addressing the long-standing issue of Sitio Kalatong dating back to 2017 which affects both environmental and indigenous communities, ICES, in the area. He also suggested scheduling weekly hearing to expedite actions against encroachers on ancestral domain and emphasized the importance of scrutinizing land purchasers to ensure legality. A Davao City Councilor announced that an Australian firm is keen and advancing the waste to energy WTE project, which was previously halted after the Japan International Cooperative Agency JICA withdrew its support. Councilor Timujin Ortec Ocampo said during the Aprobado sa Consejo Media Forum on Tuesday morning, May 14, 2024, at the Sangguniang Panglungsod, that an Australian firm along with its European partner experience in energy generation has expressed interest in the WTE project. Ocampo, who chairs the Committee on Environment and Natural Resources, mentioned that the Davao City Investment Promotion Center, DCIPC, is currently in discussion with these firms, which intends to implement a new waste conversion technology without incineration. Second District Councilor Al Ryan Alejandre underscored the importance of establishing an association for bloggers in collaboration with the City Information Office, CIO. This initiative aims to guide bloggers in creating content, particularly in promoting critical watershed areas as tourist destinations. Let us promote and be responsible tourists in the city. We need to know the parameters of the tourism sites we promote. We need first to study if we allow the tourism in the area, he said. Speaking at the Green Influence, a forum on advocating for sustainable ecotourism on Wednesday morning, May 15, 2024, at the Davao City Investment and Promotion Center, DCIPC, Alejandre, who chairs the Committee on Tourism and Beautification, expressed his hope that the City Tourism Operations Office, CTOO, would compile a list of locations for bloggers. This list would indicate whether an area is protected and specify the visitors' capacity allowed. Arturo Insalada, founder of Viajero, Davao Hikers League, welcomed Alejandre's proposal for a bloggers association as valuable platform to disseminate the information discussed in the forum. Arturo Insalada, founder of Viajero, Davao Hikers League welcomed Alejandre's proposal for a bloggers association as a valuable platform to disseminate the information discussed in the forum. The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines Davao Region, CAAP Davao, confirmed that they have monitored several flights of Pastor Apollo Kibuloy's helicopter since May 1, 2024. Four flights operation were recorded through the radar, with one of them being canceled for unknown reasons. Katong May 1, naatay na monitor, pero kadali raman to. Wala po ta kabaloon sa tuyo ato, pero allowed man sila to fly since May 1. We have monitored their flights, but the purpose remains unclear. They are permitted to fly, said Rumel Chaunoy, CAAP Davao Security Supervisor, in an exclusive interview with Sunstar Davao last Monday, May 13. On Wednesday, May 15, CAAP Davao also confirmed in an interview with DXDC RMN that these activities were indeed taking place based on their live flight tracker. National News. A flotilla of about 100 mostly small fishing boats led by Filipino activists sailed Wednesday to a dispute Sual in the South China Sea, where Beijing Coast Guard and suspected militia ship had used powerful water cannons to ward off what they regard as intruders. The Philippine Coast Guard and Navy deployed one patrol ship each to keep watch from a distance on the activities of the activists and fishermen, who set off on wooden boats with bamboo outriggers to assert Manila's sovereignty over the Scarborough Shoal. Dozens of journalists joined the three-day voyage. Activists and volunteers, including Roman Catholic priests belonging to a non-government coalition called Atin Ito, Tagalog for This Is Ours, plan to float small territorial buoys and distributed food packs and fuels to Filipino fishermen nearby the Sual. Organizers said, adding they were prepared for contingencies. Mayor Anthony Joseph Torres of this town issued Executive Order Number 2024-009B, suspending classes and work in the municipality on May 17, Friday. This is in line with the celebration of the 43rd Aldo Ning Balin Guagua Foundation Day. Torres has suspended classes in the public and private schools and work in the municipality to allow residents celebrate the important event. The order is based on the Municipal Ordinance Number 10-S-2018, which declares May 17, 1590 as the founding date of the town based on historical records. International news. Ukraine has pulled back its troops from several villages in the border region of Kharkiv following continued pressure from Russian forces. Soldiers have come under heavy fire and moved to more advantageous position. In two areas of the northeastern region, a military spokesperson said, throughout the course of the two-year war, Ukraine has typically used this type of language to signify the retreat. President Vladimir Zelensky has canceled all upcoming foreign trips as troops struggle to contain the new cross-border incursion, with several towns and villages coming under heavy fire. His press secretary, Sergey Nikiforov, said the president had instructed that all the international events scheduled for the coming days be postponed and new dates coordinated. Moscow has claimed its forces have now taken control of two more settlements in the region. Lukyansk and Lvivok and the village of Rubutin in the southern Zaporizhia region. U.S. Senator Bob Menendez's defense has sought to shift blame for his alleged bribe-taking to his wife in opening statement at his corruption trial. Nadine Menendez kept him in the dark on financial matters, the politician attorney Abby Weitzman told the jury. But prosecutor Lara Pomeranz said Mr. Menendez, 70, used his wife as a go-between in trading political influence for money, gifts, and gold bars. The long-serving New Jersey Democrat put his power up for sale, she said. Mr. Menendez is accused of accepting bribes, including gold bars and a Menendez Benz or Mercedes-Benz convertible in exchange for helping foreign governments. He has pleaded not guilty to all charges. The trial in Manhattan Federal Court could stretch to July. Mr. Menendez is required to attend each day. Entertainment news. Bridgerton is back with all its glamorous outfits, glittering ballrooms, and of course, gossiping aristocrats. The third season of Netflix period drama focused on the relationship between Penelope Featherington, played by Nicola Coughlan, and her longtime crush Colin Bridgerton, played by Luke Newton. But away from tales of love and lusts, fans might also notice a change in how both stars look. They've undergone a glow-up. Bridgerton's costume designer John Glazer tells BBC News. He said, in season one and two, Penelope was young and insecure and was being forced by her mother to wear bright yellow and bright greens. ABS-CBN News caught up with the Miss Universe Queen during the launch of the National Art Month, organized by the National Commission for Culture and Arts, where she has been the ambassador for 4 years straight. 2024, a lot of investing in personal growth. I want to challenge myself this year. I'm going out of my comfort zone, getting into business as well, which is something that allows me to challenge myself in different ways. But after getting engaged, it's trying to not with fiancé, Sam Milby, happening this year? Definitely a part of it naman, she said. She added, very excited for the new chapter, new beginnings this year, and also just, a lot of personal growth. Catriona and Sam reveal news about their engagement last February 16, 2023. The actor made it Instagram official with photos saying he's grateful that the road led him to Catriona, the love of his life. Their relationship started in 2018 when photos of the two surfaced online. It was in May 2020, Sam's birthday, when the actor made it official and announced that they are in relationship. And for the sports, NU has season MVP Belia Belen and finals MVP Alaysa Solomon. But it took a total team effort from Lady Bulldogs to reclaim the UAAP Women Volleyball title in the season 86. After its harsh reality check last season, National University has completed its mission of reclaiming the UAAP Women Volleyball title. However, the championship was not the sole objective for team captain Erin Pangilinan. She also aimed to foster a strong team culture within the Lady Bulldogs. For the 5'7" middle blocker, this culture meant a team that was not solely focused on its stars, Belia Belen and Alaysa Solomon. Manager Brendan Rodgers says he never had any doubts about himself or Celtics' title credentials after they sealed their 12th Scottish Premiership triumph in the last 13 season. The league leaders needed just a point at Kilmarnock to get over the line but dismantled the Ayrshire side 5-0 to clinch a third straight top flight crown in style. Questions have been asked of Rodgers, who returned to the club under a cloud of controversy at times this season. But the Celtics boss said his side stays focused to hold up a Rangers side who are 6 points back with one game left. There was a lot of pressure on the players, but you only need to look at the result of the performances to show how they coped, Rodgers told BBC Scotland. It means a lot for me. There were questions marks over me. Was good enough to be here? Could I manage this team? Could I get them to play the level of football expected? If you doubt, it can be an issue for you. But I never had any doubts this season. As the season has gone on, waves got better and better. For the featured stories, every year, millions of people celebrate the founder of Buddhism birth by enjoying free meals at temples. After the cherry blossom petals fall, strings of papers, lanterns begin to appear across South Korea, dangling from trees and lacing the streets to announce the arrival of Buddha's birthday. Temple visitors are greeted with a kaleidoscope of colors and the day of the celebration, which has been recognized as the national holiday for nearly 50 years in South Korea, where 16% of the population is Buddhist and can often enjoy the free bowl of sachal bibimbap, temple bibimbap, packed with seasonal vegetables representing Obang Saek, the five colors of the universe, after braving the long lines that is. A celebration of springtime, Buddha's birthday will take place on May 15 this year, with millions of people in Korea expected to come together to commemorate the birth of Siddhartha Gautama, the wandering ascetic and religious teacher who founded Buddhism in the 6th and or 5th centuries BCE. Filipino content creator Abigail Marquez took home the 2024 People's Voice Award for Food and Drinks in Social at the 2024 Webby Awards in New York City, dubbed as the Oscars of the Internet. The Webbies are awards for excellence given by the International Academy of Digital Arts and Sciences. I feel like this is one of the biggest goals that you would want. Marquez said, I started as a content creator 2 years ago and so I am here. In the social media space in the Philippines, Marquez has come to be known as Lumpia Queen. And for the side stories, let's watch this. For the trivia, do you know that the iconic Philippine flagpole, one of the tallest in the country, is located in Davao City? This towering symbol of national pride stands proud on the grounds of Rizal Park. That's all our news for today. Please like, share, subscribe, and click the bell button for you to be updated of the activities of the Pinoy Rab News Channel, Davao. This is Gilbert Lopez Martie Cacho. Good morning.